So good morning students. Previously I have taught you about the water resources and what are the types of sources of water, what are the sources of water. So first one is our surface water and second one is your groundwater. So surface water, it includes the river water, rain water, lake water, sea water. So rain water is the purest form of water because it doesn't dissolve any kind of minerals in this water. So it is the most purest form of water. And sea water, it is the most polluted water because we people are polluted those water. Okay, next is our groundwater. So it is the water found underground in the cracks and spaces in soil, sand and rock underneath the surface of the earth. So these are the sources of water. Next is our dam. Okay, so what do you mean by dams? So dams are constructed on rivers to produce electricity and irrigation facilities, etc. But in other side, for construction of dams, hundreds and thousands of areas of lands are getting destroyed because we getting the electricity. Dams helps a lot for irrigation purposes, for drinking and cooking purposes, for inland navigation, for hydropower generation. But due to land also, hundreds of areas of lands are getting destroyed. So there are also various benefits of dams, and in the same way there are various environmental effects of dams. Okay, so what are the benefits of dams? So water is essential for survival for all forms of life in the earth. So it is not evenly distributed all over the world, and even its availability at the same locations is not uniform over the year. Okay, while the parts of the world which are scarce in water are prone to drought, and other parts of the world which are abundant in water face challenging job of optimally managing the available water resources. Okay, so dams contribute significantly in fulfilling the basic human needs, and these are first one is water for drinking and industrial use. Second one is our for irrigation. Third is flood control. Fourth is inland navigation, and fifth is our hydropower generation. So firstly, I will tell you about water for drinking and industrial use. So due to large variations in hydrological cycle, dams and reservoirs are required to be constructed to store water during periods of surplus water availability and conserve the same for utilization during lean periods when the water availability is scarce. So properly designed and well constructed dams play a great role in optimally meeting the drinking water requirement of the people. Water stored in the reservoir is also used vastly for meeting industrial needs. Regulated flow of water from reservoirs help in diluting harmful dissolved substances in river waters during lean periods by supplementing low inflows, and thus in maintaining and preserving quality of water within safe limits. Next is our for irrigation. So dams and reservoirs provide service to the mankind for meeting irrigation requirements. Next is, it is estimated that 80% of additional food production by the year 2025 would be available from the irrigation made possible by dams and reservoirs. So dams and reservoirs are most needed for meeting irrigation requirement of developing countries, large parts of which are arid zones. Arid means dryness. So there is a need for construction of more reservoir based project despite widespread measures developed to conserve water through other improvements in irrigation technology. Next is flood control. So dams and reservoirs men have been many a time playing havoc with the life and property of the people. Dams and reservoirs can be effectively used to control floods by regulating river water flows downstream the dam. Okay, so the dams are designed, constructed and operated as per a specific plan for routing floods through the basin without damage to the life and property of the people. The water conserved by means of dams and reservoirs at the time of flood can be utilizing for meeting irrigation and drinking water requirements and hydropower generation. So next is inland navigation. Enhanced inland navigation is a result of comprehensive basic planning and development utilizing dams, locks and reservoirs that are regulated to play a vital role in realizing large economic benefits of national importance. Next is our hydropower generation. Energy plays a key role for socio-economic development of a country. Hydropower provides a cheap, clean and renewable source of energy. Hydropower is the most advanced and economically viable source among all the renewable energy sources. So reserve-based hydroelectric projects provide much needed peaking power to the grid. The reserve is made possible by constructing a dam, presents a beautiful view of lake. Unlike the thermal power station, hydropower station have fewer technical constraints and the hydro machines are capable of quick start and taking instantaneous load variation. In the areas where natural surface water is the scarce, the reserves are a source of recreation. So these are the various benefits of dams. First one is our these are the various benefits of dams. So first is our water for drinking and industrial use. Second is our irrigation. Third is our flood control. Fourth is our hydropower generation. And fifth is our inland navigation. So next is our the effects of dams. So there are various effects of dams. The environmental effects of dams are numerous and varied and includes direct impacts to the biological world. So some of these are, first one is our soil erosion. Next is our species extinction impact on fish, spread of diseases, changes to earth rotation and degradation of water quality. So these are the various effects of dams. Next is our uses of water. So water is used for different purposes like cooking, drinking, agricultural purposes, industrial purposes, generating hydroelectric power, etc. So these are the various uses of water resources. Next is our over exploitation of water. If we don't control the misuse of water, if we are misusing the water resources, then one day it will finish. So we need to control it. We need to control the misuse of water. So we need to properly use the water, and also we need to know the value of water. The need of water has increased rapidly with the increase in population. Over exploitation of water resources has caused the continuous decrease of normal water level. India is blessed with good water resources, but its distribution over the country is not proper. So the steps taken to avoid problem is the proper management of the ground resources. If we are not managing the ground resources water, then we are going to face a lot of problems in future. So we need to control it, and also we need to manage the ground water resources. Okay. Next is our flood. What do you mean by flood? A flood is an overflow of water that submerged the land nearby any water body, which would usually remain dry. During floods, people move themselves and their precious belongings to a higher ground for safety. So due to excessive rain flood, excessive rainfall, floods occurs. So it's a natural disaster and we cannot control it. Next is our drought. A drought is a period of below average precipitation in a given region, resulting in prolonged shortages in the water supply, whether atmospheric or surface water or groundwater. So it occurs due to the deficiency of rainfall. In India, West Bengal, Madhya Pradesh, Andhra Pradesh, Bihar, Jharkhand, Odisha, etc. are suffering from high frequency of droughts, flood and droughts. Due to excess rainfall, flood occurs, and due to the lack of rainfall, due to the deficiency of rainfall, the droughts occurs. Thank you.